And when do I end?
You must leave a legacy.
Mm-hmm. You are reset. Mm-hmm. When you are reading absent from church, no one recognizes it because you are not doing it. You are this one, but nobody is hearing of you. But the Bible declares that the whole creation is waiting for the manifestation of the sons and the daughters of God.
Amen.
This year, as professor, with my eyes open, so that I can see your face clear.
Yes.
That this year, you will manifest in the you are unstoppable.
Yes,
you are undefeatable.
Yes.
Nothing can stop you.
Yes.
What will people remember you for? What will I be remembered for? What will I, as a pastor, as a church member, as a deacon, as a presiding leader, what will you be remembered for by God? Mm-hmm. In history, family, government, church, and media. There are some people, if they only come in the media, then they have committed atrocities, wicked things, bad things. But it is time for you and I to make news.
Yeah.
The world must hear of us.
Amen.
I said the world must hear of us.
Amen.
I don't know where I'm coming from. Standing here, it is a testimony.
Amen.
When you know where I'm coming from, I speak to people, I don't understand their language. But God still ministers to them.
Amen.
You can hear it clearly. You are the right candidate.
Amen.
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 And the Bible said the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. They are new every morning. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now, the understanding of your vision will make you great.
Amen.
If you understand the reason why you are here, it will make you great.
Amen.
God has a plan and a purpose for your life. According to Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 1 to 4, the Bible says that when thou art a clot of blood in the womb of your mother, I ordain thee as a prophet to the nations of the world. And said in it, do not be afraid of their faces. For I the Lord will be with you and I will deliver you.
Amen.
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 Say that. You know, I'm speaking prophetically. God said that as far as Abraham, your eyes can see. When I say anything, say it. Don't be so gentle. But from the time we talk about this until now, the kingdom of God is suffering from all the violent. Using every possible means to bring somebody to Christ. If you need to take the ground, take it. If you need to jump for one soul to be saved, do it.
Amen.
That's what God has done.
Amen.
And verse 10 says, see, this day I have set thee over nations and kingdoms.
Amen.
To prove that.
Amen.
As I said, why are you in Australia here? Nothing is too bigger than God.
Yes.
I said, nothing is too bigger than God.
Yes.
So don't allow the limitations of life. Don't allow the present circumstances, the difficulties, the challenges that you are going through. Don't allow it to push you into a place.
Amen.
You are called for a higher call.
Yes.
This day, see, I have set thee over nations and over kingdoms to pull down, to destroy, to build. Warfare, I don't have it. But they are mighty through God to the pulling down of home of the enemy. When I say Makoko, don't be offended. I'll interpret it in English. Excuse me for my language. There's something when I'm preaching in Ghana, back in my church, I say Makoko, Makoko. And they say Mahaha, Mahaha.
Amen.
Makoko, Makoko. In other words, by the grace of God, I'm prospering. By the grace of God, I'm succeeding. That's why we call Mahaha.
Mahaha.
Yeah, yeah, you can interpret it to be prospering. Yeah. Mahaha. Mahaha. That's right.
I came to this hour. Father,
glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven saying, I have both glorified it and I will glorify it again.
Amen.
May the Lord release the secrets in that and revelation in that scripture unto all of us.
Amen.
John chapter 18 verse 37. Pilate therefore said to him, are you a king? Then Jesus answered, you say rightly that I am a king. For this cause I was born, and for this cause I have come into the world, that I should bear witness to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice. Like this morning.
Amen.
Jeremiah 1:4. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, before I formed you in the womb, at whom I knew you, before you were born, I sanctify you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations. Verses 8. Do not be afraid of their faces, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of His Holy Scripture in your heart and my heart. Will you say a big amen?
Amen.
This is the plan of God for you. When Jesus came on this face of the earth, He knew exactly the reason why He was born. Have you asked yourself, like earlier on I asked you, why have you God brought you to this church? In fact, the work that you are doing, why did God allow you to do that work? In fact, anyone that you are doing, even though here there are some hindrances and limitations to some of these things I'm saying, but the word of God pierces through bones and arrows. There's nothing that can stop the word of God. I want to teach this here. Anyone that you are doing, you should, that way you should do it. But at the same time, you must use that work to win souls for the kingdom.
Amen.
In other words, do it break time, do it long time. Make time to tell somebody Jesus loves you.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus loves you.
Amen.
Will you be arrested for saying Jesus loves you?
No.
Pilate asked, what is truth? What is truth? The Bible said, He has hidden this thing from the wise and the prudent, and has revealed unto us peace. There are people who cannot understand what you understand. They cannot see what you are seeing. They cannot enjoy what we are enjoying here. We have to make time to share the love of God with them. Will you say a big amen?
Amen.
I said, will you say a big amen?
Amen.